Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about a chapter that is magnetic effect of electric current. So this is like a quick revision for you before your board exams. So let us start with the first part of our magnetic effect of electric current. The first part which we are going to study is about Amperes circuital law. So we are going to learn about Amperes law. As we all know, Amperes law works with your magnetic field. So if I'm going to take a wire that is X, Y, and I'm going to pass a current I through my wire or through my conductor, what will happen? A magnetic field will get generated across it. If I'm going to take a point P at a distance R from my conductor, meaning point P liya at a distance R from my conductor, my magnetic field will be generated in a circular form, or else I can say I'm going to generate a loop that is my circular Amperean loop. My magnetic induction capital B will always act tangent to the circle. Means at any point I'm going to take my magnetic field, it will be a tangent to the circle. So let us proceed with the basic statement of our Amperes law. The basic statement of our Amperes law tells us the line integral of magnetic field of induction capital B around any closed path in a free space is equal to absolute permeability of free space, that is mu naught, times the total current flowing through the area bounded by the path. Iska matlab kya? Magnetic field acting on a small length, that is dl. Let us understand this in a more clear manner. I'm going to say magnetic induction capital B is acting on a length that is dl is always equal to. Now magnetic induction is acting on a small length that is dl, that is this point. But if I'm going to consider the entire loop, then I have to integrate it. So I'm going to get integration of B into dl. But what I see is I'm starting from point P. I'm moving in the entire circular path. Again, I'm coming to point P, means it is a closed loop. Closed loop means the point from which we are starting, we are ending at the same point. So I'm going to write a closed integral. So I got closed integral of B into dl is equal to mu naught into I, where mu naught is permeability and I is the current flowing. If I'm going to remove the vector sign, this is denoted in vector, then I'm going to write cos theta, because here I have a dot product, that is closed integral of BDL cos theta is equal to mu naught into I. From our this mathematical equation, we can again go back to our statement, that is I'm going to say the magnetic induction, or I can say the line integral of magnetic field. Now magnetic field kahan pe act ho raha hai? In a closed path. So the line integral of magnetic induction around a closed loop is always equal to the product of permeability of free space, that is mu naught, and current I flowing through the conductor. So that becomes the basic statement of our Amperes law in a simplified manner. So here B is our magnetic induction, dl is our small length, mu naught is permeability of free space, I is current, and theta is the angle between B and dl. So here we have completed our Amperes law. Now let us proceed to the applications of our Amperes law. Now our first question comes is, derive an expression for magnetic induction at a point near infinitely long straight conductor carrying an electric current on the basis of Amperes law. Matlab kya ek long straight conductor hai hum log ke paas, usme se hum log ne pass kiya hai current I. Ek point liya P at a distance of small r from the conductor. What we have to do is we have to calculate magnetic induction at point P, that is magnetic induction due to a long, infinitely long straight conductor or long straight current carrying conductor. So the first thing which I'm going to do is I have the same point P where the distance is small r. My conductor, that is XY, current is flowing through my conductor, that is I. Now what will happen, my magnetic field is going to get generated in a circular form. I'm going to mark a loop in a circular form, and that loop is called as my Amperean loop. As you all know, my magnetic induction capital B will always act in a tangential manner to my circle on a very small length, that is dl. मतलब पॉइंट पी पे मेरा मैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन कैसे गया, टेंजेंशियल गया, छोटा सा लेंथ ले लिया, दैट इज डीएल. सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीड विद आवर डेरिवेशन. अकॉर्डिंग टू एम्पियर्स लॉ, क्लोज इंटीग्रल ऑफ बी डीएल कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल टू म्यू नॉट इनटू आई. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सिंप्लीफाई दिस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एलएचएस एंड आरएचएस. First, I'm going to take LHS. What is my LHS? My LHS is close integral of BDL cos theta. Now, cos theta, angle between B and DL. Angle between B and DL is 0 degree. So, theta is equal to 0 degree. Cos 0 is equal to 1. Agar cos 0 equal to 1 ho gaya. So, the next thing what I'm going to get is, the next thing I'm getting is, therefore, we get close integral of B into DL. Abhi B hai hum log ka magnetic induction which is constant. What is changing my length? Mera length change ho raha hai kyunki maine initially kya liya tha? Ek chota point pe mera length le liya tha DL. Mereko kahan find karna hai? Pure ke pure circle mein find karna hai. So I am going to take out B as a constant and close integral of DL. Now as it is a circle, so what is integration of DL? The total length of the circle is circumference of the circle, which is always equal to 2 pi into r. So I got my equation number 1 as b into 2 pi into r. That is my equation number 1. Now after that, I'm going to move to my RHS. My RHS was mu naught into I. I can't do anything to it. So directly it is equation number 2. Equating equation number 1 and 2, we get, if I'm going to equate my equation number 1 and 2, that is LHS equal to RHS. B into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught into I. Meko kiska value nikalna tha? B ka value nikalna tha. 2 pi r niche jayega. That is B is equal to mu naught into I upon 2 pi into r. Abhi, I don't know the value of mu naught upon 2 pi, but I do know the value of mu naught upon 4 pi. Mu naught upon 4 pi ka value kya rehta hai? 10 to the power minus 7. Mu naught upon 2 pi ko meko banana hai, mu naught upon 4 pi. What I'm going to do? I'm going to multiply it by 2 and divide it by 2. If I'm going to multiply it by 2 and divide it by 2, meko kya milega? B is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi into 2i upon r. And this becomes the basic formula of my Amperes law, where the value of mu naught upon 4 pi is 10 to the power minus 7 Weber per ampere meter. So this is the final answer for a current carrying long straight conductor, or I can say magnetic induction at a point at a distance r from a long straight current carrying conductor. And this becomes the first application of our Amperes law. Thank you.